time for King of Dragon Pass. We're here. It's sea season. 1374. Somehow King Derek is still alive. He's 72 years old, guys. He's one of the oldest characters I've seen in this game. I don't think he's the oldest character I've seen. Oh, excuse me. Oh, too many fizzy drinks. Anyway, yeah. I think 76 is the oldest character I've ever seen in King of Dragon Pass. But yeah, he's definitely getting on. Anyway, we do have a bit of an issue. In the previous stream, we almost ended, or I think we did sort of end, on the Chaos Skirt event, which has made Natalina very, very ill. So I think what we should do right off the bat is try and cast the curing blessing. I know we've already got it active right now, but we need to try and get Natalina back up and running. So yeah, I'm willing to overdo this a little bit just to try and get some try and get Natalina back, because there is a chance that Natalina could still die. I think the Chaos Skirt event may be inflicting a special condition on Natalina. I'm not sure. Sacrifice to Uroks, obviously. We should probably do that as well. But we need to try and get Natalina up and active. Jelana Arroy cured 4 of the 6. She could do nothing for Natalina. Okay, so something is definitely affecting her. Too many hunters, of course. Right, a delegation from the Greenwing clan arrived, but before we learned their mission, there was a disturbance in the clan hall. Tolalang made lecherous remarks about Aranda. Her sister Venina, one of our weapon things, drew her sword and had to be restrained from attacking Tolalang. Luckily, there was no breach of hospitality, but the Greenwings are furious. This will blow over. This will eventually blow over, but it will take some time for tempers to cool. We should send them on their way with gifts. So, do we apologize for Venina's behavior? Demand an apology from Tonalang's behavior. Ask the Greenwings to return later. Ignore the incident. Ask about their business, or allow Venina to duel Tonalang. Okay. If both parties agree, a duel would not violate hospitality. I think that Tonalang and Venina are pretty evenly matched. Hospitality is sacred to the gods. If Venina had wounded Tonalang, they would have withdrawn their favor from us. If she had slain him, they would have cursed us. Okay, well, Natalina's in trouble, so... Okay, fighting won't settle anything. Asking Tonalang for an apology would not be out of place. A duel between Venina and Tonalang would resolve everything, says Gondagar, our trickster. What do we do here then? Okay. Well, I do wonder if the Greenwings would be interested to see a duel. A show of power is always generally respected, but the Green Wings are in a bad way with us. Yeah, I think we should demand an apology. There we go. Tonalang admitted that he'd momentarily forgotten how he'd want his sister treated. Vanina was pleased, but the Greenwing leader said he couldn't negotiate after such a stormy beginning, and they left. Meh, whatever, don't care. Right. This is a dodgy situation. Okay. Maybe we should. Sense chaos, perhaps? But don't we already have that active? Yeah, we already have that active. Okay, we'll go with smite chaos then, just so we're also sacrificing to Uruks. Right, we got that sorted out, and now we should probably address the hunter situation. Although our wildlands could support more hunters now, okay. Okay, so apparently we do have enough hunters, but we should probably reduce it a little bit, just in case. Magic 2. Good news! After many weeks at death's door, Natalina recovered from the illness caused by the hexed skirt. Ah. Well, that's fortunate. Okay. that went better than expected. Right. I think it might be wise for us to maybe explore the Tula a little bit. I've been doing a little bit of reading between streams just to get a handle on how to deal with this rising chaos, because there's no obvious way of reducing chaos in the general area. So I wanted to find out if there was a method we can use. And we use Brangbane, as always. Give him a few extra weapon things to work with. But yeah, I did a bit of reading into it, and apparently you can explore around your Tula to reduce banditry and chaos, so I guess we'll see if that works. We've just explored our own Tula more thoroughly. We didn't find anything interesting. Fine. Okay. Oh dear. Oh dear. Dangmar, a carl from your clan, urges you to seek a bride for him. I know people say that they find me hard to look at, but I have a good heart. I'm surely kind, and I uphold all of Valanthi's virtues. Surely I deserve a good wife. Those faces in the background. I mean, that face at the front. My word. But those faces of disgust. So, yeah, how do we deal with this? Refuse him, seek a bride for him, seek a bride, offer her clan a gift in addition to the bride price. Tell him to ask later when we're not so busy, use some trickster magic. Or say, you must accept your lot in life is to be unmarried. Oh, I'm afraid even Ermal can't help him. Well, the thing is, I do know that trickster magic would be a temporary thing. I mean, for a start, Ermal is a fickle god. So even if he would look good with the trickster magic, it won't be forever. You can guarantee that from the trickster. So, yeah, let's... Our best chance of finding a bride is amongst the Nemoldings. I wonder what Derek means by this. More important things to worry about. Trickster magic often backfires on those who use... So, yeah, as Selenarg here says... Yeah, that's not going to work out so good. It is unusual to offer gifts separate from the bride price, but it might be our only hope in this instance. It'd be very hard to convince another clan to give us a bride for him. He is ugly, true, but it's not always a bull's face that attracts a cow. That's quite a good way of putting it. I quite like that metaphor. Okay, let's seek a bride, offering her clan a gift in addition to the bride price. So let's try the Nemoldings, as our king suggests. They're known for their fine apples. So what do we offer? Let's offer them 20 goods. Surely that'll be enough. No one would marry him. Aww. Well, it was worth a shot. But it's now Earth season, so the time for fighting has passed. We might still have an opportunity to fight later on. But, well, that's that for now. Right, okay, so... Earth season... I got an... I'm thinking maybe we should explore into the upland marsh. We might find some undead in the area and get into a bit of a scrap. Maybe reduce some of the chaos in the area, seeing as the undead and chaos go hand in hand. Yeah, let's give that a go. And once again, I'll send Brangbane out. He's got some good magic on him now, which is interesting to see. And we'll send them to the edge, or sort of the edge of the upland marsh. Yeah. Now, who knows? Maybe it'll make the marsh ducks happier with us. That would be nice. Right, now, with that done, what shall we do? We got lots of blessings on the go already, so I don't think that's going to help us. What about Humucked? No, we got the... Oath blessing up already, so he's tapped out. Adela, we did a blessing somewhat recently, but we could probably try again, but we normally do that in dark seasons, so let's deal with that in dark season. Oh, okay. Yeah, let's make a sacrifice to Vinga for the feared women. So, I didn't realise this at the time, but I recently found out. Within the last week, that feared is actually a word used in Anglo-Saxon times to refer to levy troops. So basically farmers that are levied for battle. I was watching a thing about the battles against the Vikings and the Anglo-Saxons' response to Viking invasions. And yes, apparently that the Saxon kings would raise feards. These were the farmer levies that were available during the summertime when the crops were growing, but they would have to be released in springtime and autumn. So that they could tend to the fields. Otherwise, well, the crops would fail. Anyway, here we go. The exploration party we sent to the west found a piece of amber that glows at night. This is a drop of Elmul's blood. We should use it on a raid to shoot fire arrows. Huh. Interesting. Oh no. Many of the sheep are sick. The Carls are worried that the disease spirits will grow stronger and infest the healthy animals. They figure that 430 sheep have the disease right now. Do we destroy the diseased animals? Do we sacrifice to Navala, the sheep mother? Send for Navala priestesses from other clans? Send for shamans to drive away the disease spirits? Or separate the diseased sheep from the healthy ones? So, yeah, although destroying the diseased animals and separating the diseased sheep from the healthy ones can stop things from getting worse, they aren't the most effective solutions from what I understand. The magical responses are the ones that can work better if they work at all. The Kotars will take it hard if we don't try to heal the sheep. Okay, after this is over, we should replenish our herds by raiding a clan with lots of sheep, like the Genestni. We're not going to raid our allies and our cadet clan. Looks like our sheep herds have been unprospered. Yes. Yes, it does look like they have been. But it might be okay if we act well. It is wisest to appeal to Navala. Shamans might drive away the bad spirits, but they won't be able to cure the sheep that are already affected. Just as Yrolda is the bountiful cow mother, Navala is the ewe goddess. I can find shamans to drive away the diseased spirits. Okay, they may not come, but we should ask Navala priestesses to help us. They will know best. Whatever the rest of you decide, Gordagar. Gordagar's been a very boring trickster, I have to say. But yeah, I think we should probably send for Navala priestesses from other clans. Navala priestesses come and say that they will heal the sheep if you give them 10 healthy sheep for sacrifice to their goddess. Sure, 10 healthy sheep for up to 420 surviving. I think that's worth it. They performed their healing rituals, but said that the spirits of disease infesting the animals were too powerful. They said the sheep should be destroyed, lest the spirits grow even stronger. Well, maybe we should sacrifice to Nevala, the sheep mother. How much do you wish to sacrifice? Well, we should put in a fairly hefty sacrifice if we want this to work. I'm going to put 30 goods into this. We've got the goods for it, so we might as well. Half of the six sheep were healed by Nevala's grace. The rest died mercifully quickly. Okay, so we lost half of the infected, but thankfully we've resolved the situation. Ah, here we go again. Right. The uneasy peace between the tribes in Dragon Pass is broken again. Oranda, a trader of your clan, reports that she had to leave her goods and run from a battle between the Esterelda and the Kolimar tribes. The battles between the Esterelda and the Kolimar threaten to plunge all of Dragon Pass into warfare. It's not enough that Malesta, Queen of the Esterelda, plans to cripple the Kolimar, or that Gustund, the King of the Kolimar, promises to annihilate Malesta and her tribe. The warring tribes are also threatening their neighbours to join them or fight them. The result of this is that the slightest provocation could set all of Dragon Pass at war with itself. The spirits of our ancestors say that we will have very little time to decide what we want to do before we're caught in the crush of tribal war. Okay, well, let's try to offer to broker peace between the warring tribes. It's always the best option here, I think. So, who heads the delegation to the Esterelda? Well, we should probably send... We've managed to persuade Marlesta previously, but it was unsuccessful with the other clan that was involved. So, we should try again. This time give Derek the task of trying to persuade the Esterelda, and then put Enant in charge of persuading the Kolimar. Hopefully this works. The Esterelda queen would not hear of peace. She was determined to succeed through war. Enant convinced the king of the Kolimar that it was time to stop the war. Oh dear, Marlesta, please, you're causing too many problems. Got half a mind to send a raid to Marlesta, reduce her numbers a bit. But it is dark season, so that means it is time to sacrifice to Odela for the Yinkin blessing. Hopefully Odela will listen to us this time. No, Odela doesn't care. I guess we'll just try again. But we'll give a few extra goods this time. There we go. He listened this time. Traders tell you that the elves have raided the Orlad Nasty, who are members of the Kolimar tribe. It's worse than the usual raid. The Orlad Nasty have lost many lives and much wealth. Huh. Okay. So, do we demand tribute? Do we do nothing? Do we give them gifts? Do we tell them another clan sent the elves after them? Do we tell them that we sent the elves after them? Gordengar thinks we should cause some problems and say this is an excellent chance to get two foes at one another's throats. The Orlad Nasty should be eager to join us in the war against the elves, of course. Tarkala, rather, is... for whatever reason, highly anti-elf. I can't say I disapprove of that. Derek says we will gain their esteem by helping them. If we threaten them, we'll gain their hatred. Yep, very true. We're not obligated to help them. True. I've heard that there are shamans in the area who seek out clans who have just been raided. They offer to send bad spirits against the enemies of those who had hired them. Bad King Urgrain sent trolls against King Voskath. Then Voskath sent elves against King Urgrain. Great. Fantastic. If we tell them we sent the elves after them, they'll be even more afraid and cough up tribute, the tribute we demand. Enant, thinking business, as always. I mean, I guess I can't really complain about the entrepreneurship of Enant here, but I think that's crossing the line a little bit. So let's give them gifts. We'll hopefully help them out a bit here. Should probably give them some gifts, give them 40 goods, and we got the food to spare, so let's give them 100 food as well. Their gratitude was unrestrained. So, yeah, I mean, we get a fair amount of spoiled food each year, so getting rid of some of it is, well, probably in our best interest. But it is now storm season, so the snows are starting to recede. But we could still get trapped in muddy conditions, so... So it's the Assaultings who are currently the host clan for the Colimars. We were able to persuade them. I think it's the Orlundi who are... Yeah. It's the host clan of the Esterelda. Looks like your clan ring... uses some uncommon senses instead of common... Perhaps, yes. There's definitely some out-of-the-box thinking there from Enant. And Tarkala as well. Gondagar's being his usual self, looking to cause some mischief wherever possible. So, yeah. I think it might be an idea to send an emissary out to... the Orlandi. Send them food, I think, is a good idea, and send them some gifts as well. Orlandi, give gifts, and who shall we send? We shall send Brangbane. We definitely want this caravan to arrive, so I'm going to send 12 weapon thanes along. Okay, so we're giving gifts. Brangbane is our man for the job, and we are sending it to the Orlandi. Oh, but we're being raided by the Tree Brothers, of course, just as we... Just as we decide to send a third of our dudes out. Okay, well, we'll drive them off. We'll charge. We'll use the splinter rock as always. Luckily, our patrols spotted their 18 horsemen and 184 swordsmen, so they're met by 19 of our weapon thanes and 225 of the feared, so... Actually, maybe we could do a little more damage and try and kill as many as possible. Yeah, I think we'll do that. I think that it'll be more trickster-ish of Gordiger to actually give good advice. Yeah, every once in a while a trickster will do that, so yeah... Okay, let's go. We struck the splinter rock with a sword, releasing a shower of sparks and a strong wind that blew towards our foe. We rushed the tree brother formation while they were still sacrificing to their gods. There was an extended clash. We were driven from the battlefield, and the tree brothers made off with 6 horses. They took 4 cows worth of loot. After the battle, we realized that the splinter rock had shattered into tiny pieces. Oh well. Due to the prompt healing, our auxiliaries kept 1 warrior from dying and patched up 3 of the wounded. But man, did they lose a lot of troops from that. 4 weapon thanes and 21 of their footmen were killed in that battle. We lost 9 of our footmen, but that's nothing compared to the damage we'd done to them. Okay. Well, I guess it means war. But that does mean we can go and recruit some more weapon thanes. They'll offer from outside the clan. Let's also try and recruit some of the carls as well. Our population has gone above the 1,000 mark again, so we are in a good situation regarding our population. And we do get another 4 weapon thanes. The Orlandi extravagantly praised our gifts. They toasted me in their feasting hall, drinking far into the night and singing many rousing songs with me. They said that we were their friends and that we could call on them in the future if we needed to. I hear that the Cardavi clan lost 3 of its weapon thanes. Ophir, the Cardavi chief, offended them by arguing that a blue tunic was in fact black. Okay. What on earth happened there? My goodness. But that is the end of that year. So, for those of you on YouTube, you know what time it is. It's time to say take care and have fun, and I'll see you in the next video.